Legacy Maker, the All Sports Network.
Mike Leffler.
Hello, everybody. The Real Ones Legacy Maker Sports Network here to bring you to broadcast women's college basketball action between the UMass men and women and the Richmond Spiders. Richmond Spiders come here 5-15. So they come into a UMass team who come off a really tough loss to TCU, who's number one in the conference right now. It's 48, which we were at that game the other day. But nevertheless, they're 11-10. They're 3-4 in the conference and looking to make some strides today in this game. So we're going to take you over to the broadcast. Enjoy the game. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to today's matchup, A-10 college basketball, women's college basketball, as the UMass men and women come into the Robin Center to take on the Richmond Spiders here in Richmond, Virginia. Starting lineups, ladies and gentlemen, for the UMass men and women. First, Anil Soysil, the center, 6'5", freshman from Israel, Turkey. Next, we have Jessica George, the 5'10 senior from Waldorf, Maryland. Then we got Venice Perry, the 5'6 junior from La Crosse, Georgia. Then the all-time UMass leader in three-pointers, Haley Liddell, guard, 5'11 junior from Brownstown, Michigan. And then leading them, or finishing up the lineup here for this UMass team is Asia McCoy, the 5'10 freshman from Lawrenceville, Georgia. Now what you're hearing in the background is the Richmond Spiders lineup. Starting for the Richmond Spiders, number one, Jade Hines Clark, the freshman junior, 6'1 from Westwood, New Jersey. Right now she leads this team in conference play with 12 points per game. Then you got Deja Ruffin, the guard, 5'9, a transfer, Louisville, Kentucky. She's also starting here. Guard Alex Parson, leading the team in scoring overall with 10.8 points per game. Freshman from North Chesterfield, Virginia. Molly Mraz, freshman from Erie, Pennsylvania. And, of course, Amy Duggan, the freshman junior from Norwood, Mass. So she's taking on her hometown state today in this matchup. So, once again, glad to have you all here with us. We're excited for a great contest as we're about to get this first quarter underway. Two teams trying to continue to keep things rolling in the A-10. And, you know, this UMass team, we saw them play the other day against VCU, and they put up an amazing effort. The turnovers cost this team in the end in that ball game. They had plenty of opportunity to win that game, but just small mistakes here and there cost the team. Liddell led the way in that contest with 16 points for UMass, but she had great contributions from Destiny Philoxy and young ladies like that. So we're going to see a good matchup here today as the tip is about to get underway. Hines Clark wins the tip over McCoy, and we're here for the action. Duggan has it on the right wing, swings it to Mraz. Mraz at the top of the key over to Parson, who gets it down low to Hines Clark, and she starts the game off right with the right-handed hook in the lane for 2 points. 2-0 Richmond Spiders. Liddell has it, being guarded by Mraz, hands it off to Perry. Perry being guarded by Alex Parson, third team all A-10 preseason. Liddell swings it over to Perry for three, and that bounces off the back of the rim. She gets her own rebound. Great hustle there by Perry. This UMass team coming off once again that tough loss against VCU on Wednesday, trying to complete the Virginia trip with a victory today. Trying to get it to Soysil. She lost control, and Deja Ruffin brings it up the floor here for the Spiders. Swings it in the right corner to Alex Parson, who lost control, trying to get it to Hines Clark. And here comes the fast break. George up to Perry, and she is going to get called for traveling. 2-0 Richmond Spiders, 8 minutes and 48 seconds here in the first period. Spiders looking for win number three here in the A-10 Conference, and would be which would also be their third win in a row. Ruffin has it in the paint, kicks it out to Hines Clark from the right elbow, misses off the back of the rim. George with the rebound. And George up the floor, driving towards the basket, kicks it over in the left corner. And Perry gets the bounce, hit off the side of the rim, and then bops on in for UMass 3. And now UMass has a 3-2 lead with 8 minutes and 8 seconds on the clock. Mraz gives it down low to Hines Clark, who takes it on the baseline but cannot bring it in. It rolls off the side, and George takes it up the floor here for UMass. George takes a couple of dribbles, passes to Perry, and Perry hits it from the corner. 3 number 2 here for Vinnie Perry. Perry, great start here. 6-2 UMass after 2 threes from Perry. Ruffin has it. Kicks it out to Parson. Parson to Mraz for 3, and that rattles out. Rebound Perry. Perry's doing it all here for UMass to get started. And now she's going to take it back and slow things down here. 7 minutes and 21 seconds left here in this first period. Spiders seeming to be in a little bit of trouble to start this game. George for 3, blocked by Ruffin. Good hustle there. Lydell gets the rebound there for UMass. Perry for 3, bangs it in. What a shot. Oh, man, Perry. A little bit of Steph Curry range there by Perry. She's got the first 9 points of this game. 3 straight threes from Perry. Mraz for 3. She misses off the side of the rim. Lydell battling with Ruffin for the rebound. And Duggan also getting it in on the mix. And it will be UMass basketball. Man, what a way to start this ball game here for UMass. 3 straight threes. And Venice Perry starting it off the right way. 6 minutes and 40 seconds here. If you're Richmond, you're going to have to find a way to get a hold of Perry here because she's already got 9. She is not playing games to start this one. She's been wide open on all of those attempts. Sosil has it, takes a dribble, hands it off to George. George then hands it off to McCoy. McCoy gives it over to Lydell. Lydell finds McCoy in the inside for 2 points. Right there on that right block. Great job there. 11-2, UMass. Ruffin has it in the right corner. Gives it over to Duggan. Duggan over to Parson. Parson to Mraz. Mraz over to Hines Clark. And Hines Clark is going to step out of bounds on that baseline and give the ball over to UMass. 11-2. 6 minutes and 8 seconds on the clock. And UMass off to a fantastic start in this ball game. Perry over to George. On the right wing, over to McCoy. On the left side, tries to get it inside of Soysil, and she is fouled by Hines Clark. It's going to be her first foul. And so coming in the game, Anaya Carpenter coming in for Parson. So we'll get to see Anaya Carpenter, the freshman, 5'8", from Baltimore, Maryland. Averaging 5.9 points a game here for the Richmond Spiders. George has it in the far corner. Inside. Beautiful pass to Perry. She tried to get it to Soysil, but no good. Lost control, and here come the Spiders. Ruffin on the break. And Perry is just really making an impact here for UMass to start this game. Sneaks in from behind and knocks that ball out of Ruffin's hands. Goes out of bounds. UMass basketball. Excuse me, Richmond Spider basketball. And it looks like Mraz will take it out. She hands it over to Ruffin. The right wing gives it to Carpenter at the top of the key, being guarded by George. She swings it over to the left wing to Duggan. Back to Carpenter for 3. Rattles out Soysil with the rebound. Gives it up to George. Now George has it, being guarded by Ruffin. Pulls up for 3. And that one hits off the front of the rim. And McCoy and Duggan battling. And that's going to go off of McCoy. It'll be Spiders basketball. So Emma Squires is in the game from Kingston, Massachusetts. Another Massachusetts player here on this Spiders team. She is now in the game for Duggan. And trade one for another. So Emma Squares over to Ruffin at the top of the key, being guarded by George. Back to Squares on the right wing. Then swings it over to Mraz. Inside to Hines Clark. Can't finish. Battling with Nelson, who's now in the game for UMass. Down low, and it will stay with the Spiders. Hines Clark is going to be critical, ladies and gentlemen, if this Spiders team wants to win this ball game. She is going to be a critical piece. She's gotten a lot of great opportunities so far in this ball game, just have not been able to capitalize. I guess we'll see how things go from there, as we got UMass up 11-2 with 4 minutes and 51 seconds on the clock. And we're back here from the timeout. 11-2, UMass up over the Spiders team with 4 minutes and 51 seconds on the clock. And it's been all Venice Perry. 9 points, 2 rebounds so far. She does have 2 turnovers. Got to clean that up a little bit. So as the Spiders take it out, Mraz long pass in the roughing. Being guarded by Perry. Gives it over to Cardner on the right side. And then back to roughing at the top of the key. Over to Squares. Squares down low to Hines Clark. High off the backboard. And Jade Hines-Clark, she's going to have to be that driving force for the Spiders here. 11-4. And the junior comes through. McCoy being guarded by Hines-Clark at the top of the key. Switched off to Mraz. Nice spin move in the inside. Good defense there by Hines-Clark. May have gotten a little bit of the basketball on that one. 11-4, UMass up. Mraz has it being guarded by McCoy. Swings it over to Squires, who has it over to Ruffin at the top of the key. Shoots the three, no good. And Lydell leading the break. Slow it down, give it to Perry. Now Perry taking her time here. Being guarded by Carpenter, over to George. Back to McCoy at the top of the key. Then to Perry on the left wing. Lydell at the top of the key. And Ruffin playing tough defense on George, who drives to the basket with the left hand. No good. Rebound. Hines Clark. Carpenter bringing it up the floor. Dishes it to Squire. No good. Gets the rebound. Squires kicks it out to Carpenter. She misses off the front of the rim. Rebound Lydell. Perry up the floor. Nice little crossover. Dishes it out wide open to George. Bangs it in, but they're going to call a charge against Perry. And the three will not count. But then once again, that was another three-pointer that if they wouldn't have called the charge, that would have been all in the favor of UMass. Because George was wide open. They've got to find a way to guard that corner. 11-4, UMass. Parson over to Carpenter. Top of the key for three. Bangs it in. And Carpenter gets her first points of the game. 11-7, UMass. And now in the game, Destiny Philoxi, who did it all the other day for UMass. A little bit of, ooh, and there's a foul there. And they're going to call this against Mraz. And she's looking like, wait a minute, I was on the ground. So 11-7, UMass. Men and women basketball. Lydell from the elbow with the jump shot, no good. Rebound Duggan. Up to Parson. Parson dribbles, swings it over to Carpenter from the left wing. Oh, she almost lost her foot. Carpenter kicks it back out to Parson. Parson being guarded by Philoxi. That's going to be an interesting matchup today. Philoxi is a different type of player we were talking about earlier. Carpenter off the front of the rim. Misses. Rivera. Great hustle there by Carpenter with the steal. Straight towards the basket. Dishes it to Duggan, and looks like it might have been touched last by Nelson. And it will stay with the Spiders. As And Squires will come back into the game here. 11-7, 2 minutes and 5 seconds left in this first period. And Carpenter gets the ball from the inbound. Being guarded by Phylloxi. Over to Mraz. On the right wing, back to Carpenter. Over to Parson. Now to Duggan for the jump shot on the baseline. No good. And there's a battle underneath the basket. Lionel Squires. Parson all scrambling for. And it will stay with the Spiders. 11-7 here. A minute and 50 left in this first period. It's been a pretty quick first period. As Mraz gets it inside to Squires. She's battling down a great defense by Hampton Bay. Bree Hampton Bay, who's now in the game for UMass. Also Nelson. Great defense. Now we got an 11-7 game with 1 minute and 46 seconds on the clock. Phylloxi up to George. George gives it to Hampton Bay. A nice inside pass to Jessica Nelson. It's a 13-7 ball game. Beautiful pass there by Hampton Bay. Mraz has it on the right wing. Over to Carpenter at the top of the key. Driving towards the basket. Kicks it over to Parson. Parson drives to the free throw line. Kicks it to Mraz. Back to Parson. And Parson now has it. Gives it in the score. Great ball movement here by the Spiders. They find Carpenter on the left wing. No good. And Hampton Bay gets the rebound. Lost control. And then they give it to Phylloxi. 13-7 here. 56 seconds left in this first period. Phylloxi over to George. George been guarded by Mraz. Over to Hampton Bay. And Carpenter got a piece of it. Couldn't hold on to Phylloxi. Looking down low for Nelson. 3 seconds on Nelson is the call. As Jade Hines-Clark and Ruffin head back in the game for Duggan and Mraz. For the Spiders, 13-7, 42 seconds on the clock. Carpenter brings it up the floor here for the Spiders. So right now and then for the Spiders is Carpenter, Squires, Ruffin, Hines-Clark, and Parson. And for UMass is Hampton Bay, George, Nelson, Rivera, and Phylloxi. 26.9 seconds on the clock. And 13-7. 20 seconds left as Parson is going to slow it down here and try to take the last shot of this period here for the Spiders. Coach Bader calling out a little direction here. 10 seconds. 9. No shot clock. Kicks it over to Carpenter from the corner for 3, and she bangs it in. 13-10. And Phylloxi at the end of the buzzer, no good. That's going to hit off the side of the backboard. And at the end of the first period to score, UMass 13, the Richmond Spiders 10. All right, everybody, that is the end of the first quarter. UMass up 13-10. And I'll tell you the reason why UMass is up 13-10, and that's all because of Venice Perry, who started this game off with 3 straight threes and got this UMass men and women team to an early lead in this contest. But Richmond battled back with some great play from Anaya Carpenter and Jade Hines-Clark. So as of right now, the score is 13-10 here at the end of the first period with the UMass men and women up 13-10 over Richmond. Now we'll head back for the second quarter. Ladies and gentlemen, we are back 13-10. UMass gets the ball first as George takes it out, hands it over to Perry. Perry swings it to Rivera on the right wing, back to Perry at the top of the key, and over to Hampton Bay on the left wing. They get it inside to George for the floater, no good. Spiders up the floor. Parson finds Carpenter on the right wing, who dribbles over to the top of the key, being guarded by George. 13-10, 9 minutes and 27 seconds. Pump fake by Squires. Squires drive to the basket, and it's good. And it looks like we're just making sure that it's not a charge. They're going to say an and-one situation here for Emma Squires. Great job. Drives to the basket and puts it in, being guarded by Hampton Bay. And now this is a one-point UMass lead as the Spiders have crawled their way back into this ball game, and Squires has an opportunity to tie this game up at 13. It's good. 13-13. No. Spiders have battled all the way back, being down 11-2 at one point, and have now went on an 11-2 run of their own, 13-13. And Perry has it at the top of the key for UMass, swings it over to Rivera, who sends it cross court to George, and she lost control of it out of bounds. Spiders basketball. Now, this is a thing that costs UMass in the last game. Is the turnovers. And right now they're struggling a little bit here after starting off great. And now the Spiders have crawled their way back into this game with a chance to take the lead for the first time since the score was 2-0. Carpenter over to Squires. Squires inside to Hines Clark, who then swings it over to the right corner to Parson. Parson gives it over to Carpenter at the top of the key. It's over to Squires on the left side. And then Hines Clark driving to the inside, and she's going to be fouled. And they're going to say under the basket here for Richmond as Carpenter's taking it out. 30 seconds on the shot clock. Hines Clark gets there on the rebound, lost control of it. It rolls off her knee, hits her foot, and goes out of bounds. UMass basketball. 13-13, 8 minutes and 42 seconds on the clock. As Liddell is going to be fouled by Carpenter in the far corner. UMass takes it out. Perry over to Liddell. And Liddell gives it to Rivera. Dribbles over the top of the key, gives it to Liddell on the left wing. George has it in the corner. Gives it to Nelson. Back to Liddell. Swings at the top to Perry. Being guarded by Squires. Perry driving to the basket. Good defense here by Squires and Hines Clark. They find Rivera for three at the top of the key. Hennessy's Rivera. 16-13 UMass. Squires for three. And she hits it off the side of the rim, trying to give one right back there to UMass. 16-13. 7 minutes and 52 seconds. Rivera takes a dribble, gives it over to George on the right wing, inside to Nelson with the left hand hook. No good. Carpenter with the rebound. Up the floor to Ruffin. Ruffin takes a dribble, swings across the court to Parson. Parson, a little bit of a push off there with the jump shot, and then it's good. She might have got away with one on that one. 16-15 as Parson gets on the board for the first time. UMass up one. 7 minutes and 20 seconds on the clock. Perry slowing the pace down here for the Minute Women. Gives it to George. Hands it off to Perry. Perry pump fakes. Drives inside. Kicks it in the corner to Rivera on the far left corner. It's no good. Rebound Hines Clark. 16-15, 6 minutes and 54 seconds on the clock. Parson over to Squires. Squires inside to Hines Clark with the right hand layup, and there's going to be a foul call on Hennessy's Rivera. And Coach Verde is not thrilled. It looks like he thought it was a late call, because in my opinion, it looked like it might have been a little bit of a late call there. But nevertheless, Hines Clark is heading to the line with a chance to tie the game back up. And she makes it 16-16. Hines Clark so far in the ball game, 4 points, 2-for-6 from the field, 5 rebounds. And she makes both. 17-16, Hines Clark now with 6 points. 2-for-2 from the free throw line. 17-16 Spiders as they claim their first lead since 2-0. Lyle trying to get it inside to Sorcil, who's going to get fouled. And it's going to go against Amy Duggan. And Sosil will head to the line. Anil Sosil from Turkey, 6'5". Redshirt freshman. With a chance to tie back up. And she does, 17-17. As McCoy has made her way back into the game. Sosil to retake the lead. And that hits off the side of the rim. Duggan with the rebound for the Spiders. Hands it off to Parson and she brings it up the floor. 6 minutes and 26 seconds, 21 seconds on the shot clock. Ruffin being guarded by George. Swings over to Parson, top of the key. Over to Duggan on the left wing. Ruffin at the top of the key for three. Deja Ruffin. It's a 2017 game. So Ruffin gives the Spiders the lead right back. And stolen by Amy Duggan on the fast break. All alone, and she got it. Amy Duggan, 22-17, Richmond Spiders. Great effort there by Amy Duggan. Gets the steal and takes it straight to the basket for the 2 points. And UMass right back as Lydell gets it in inside to Soysil to make this a 22-19 game. 5 minutes and 32 seconds on the clock. Parson at the top of the key for three. Bangs it in. And just like that, it's become a three-fest in here on Super Bowl Sunday. 25-19, 5 minutes and 14 seconds. And the Spiders' lead is now 6. McCoy has it. Takes a shot for three. No good. And rebound, Hines Clark. Hines Clark gives it up to Parson. She brings it up the floor. Trying to slow it down here. Spiders holding on to a 6-point lead here in the second period. Raz over to Ruffin at the top of the key. On the left wing to Parson. Lost control. Gets it in the Hines Clark. Back to Parson for the jump shot. It's good. And Parson from the baseline, and this is an 8-point Spiders lead with 4 minutes and 34 seconds on the clock. What a nice little run here for the Richmond Spiders. I mean, they went on a 25-6 run, and right now, the Richmond Spiders lead 27-19 with 4 minutes and 34 seconds left in the second period. And we are back here from the timeout. 27-19 as the Spiders have taken full control here going on that 27-6 run. Excuse me, 25-6 run here, giving them an 8-point lead. And George looks like she's going to be heading to the line after the foul is called on Amy Duggan. That's her second. So, actually, they're going to say that when it was on Duggan, but McCoy will be heading to the line here for UMass. And they make it a 7-point lead as McCoy hits the first. McCoy, the 5'10 freshman from Lawrenceville, Georgia, looking to make it 2-for-2 here from the free throw line, and does just that. And now UMass has put on the press, trying to put up that pressure just a little bit to get back into this ball game. Spiders holding on to the lead. Parson swings it over to Squires. Squires back to Parson at the top of the key to Mraz for three in the left corner. Off the front of the rim. Squires battling down low, but Hampton Bay gets the rebound. On the fast break, nice dish to Philoxy in the inside, and they're going to call block and foul. And this one is against Alex Parson. And Philoxy will head to the line. And I talked about how well Biloxi played in that game against the Richmond Spiders the other day. The 5'7 freshman from Queens, New York has definitely been a spark on this team. See if she'll be able to spark them back into this ball game here to make this a 4-point game, and she just does just that. 27-23, 3 minutes and 46 seconds on the clock here. Spiders trying to break this press. Hampton Bay guard Carpenter. And Carpenter over to Squires. Squires in the corner to Ruffin. Ruffin kicks it back out to Squires. Squires over to Carpenter, top of the key. Gives it to Squires on the right wing for the three. No good. Rebound. Ruffin. Ruffin. Tough in the inside. Nice layup. All the contact by Soysil and Hampton Bay did not make a difference there. Ruffin toughs that one in. 29-23. Richmond Spiders up with 3 minutes and 4 seconds here in the second period. Hampton Bay driving to the basket. Blocked by Hines Clark. Gets her own rebound. Biloxi at the top of the key. Swings it over to George. Takes one bounce. Drives towards the basket. Back to Biloxi. Inside to Soysil. Beautiful pass by Destiny Biloxi. She's starting to become one of my favorite players to watch. Just tough. Got to be tough when you come from Queens. I'm just saying. You got to be tough when you come from Queens. 29-25. Spiders up by 4. 2 minutes left in this first half. Hines Clark misses the layup. Tries to get her own rebound. Misses that one. Rebound, UMass. George up the floor. Gives it to McCoy on the baseline, driving to the basket. A lot of contact there with her and Hines Clark. No foul call. Spiders gain possession, 29-25. 2 minutes and 4 seconds. And now we're under the 2-minute mark. 29-25, 16 seconds on the shot clock. Ruffin being guarded by George. Swings it to Carpenter. Carpenter drives to the A-10 logo. Kicks it out to Squires for 3 in the our corner, no good. Rebound, Hines Clark, and puts it in. And the Hines Clark has come to play, ladies and gentlemen. 31-25. A minute 32 on the clock. And Biloxi is slowing things down here for UMass. Biloxi. Hampton Bay tried to bounce it off of Ruffin. Because she was falling out of bounds, Ruffin able to gain control, but then ended up losing control here at half court. And UMass basketball. Minute 14 as the Spiders hold on to a 6-point lead. And Nelson will make her way back in the game for Soysil. George takes it out at the scores table, gives it over to Biloxi. Being guarded by Carpenter. George. To Biloxi inside to Nelson, and she is going to be fouled. And Jessica Nelson will head to the free throw line. And the foul is called on Jade Hines Clark, which is her second. Clark has 8 points so far in this ball game. And Nelson will knock it down. 31-26. Nelson. Make this a 4-point game. Misses off the back of the rim. A rebound by Mustaf, who's entering the ball game. Amani Mustaf. Carpenter at the top of the key to Mraz on the left wing. Over to Squires at the top of the key. Now swings it over to Ruffin. On the right wing, back to Carpenter. Carpenter drives towards the basket. Great defense here by Biloxi. Looks inside to Mustaf, who kicks it back at the top to Ruffin. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Ruffin for 3. Rattles out. Rebound. McCoy. 31-26. 28 seconds left. Shot clock. And the game clock about a second and a half off as Biloxi calling out directions, trying to get some vision here for the UMass men and women. Trying to go in the halftime just a little bit closer. Gives it to Nelson. Nelson gives it right back to Phylloxi. Drives. Nice little pump fake in the inside. Destiny Phylloxi. 31-28. Roughing for the half court. And it's going to go just a little bit short. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is the end of the first half with the score. The Richmond Spiders 31, the UMass Men and Women 28. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that is halftime. 31-28 as of right now. The Richmond Spiders have a three-point lead. They were able to crawl out of a hole early in that first half, but they were down 13-2 at one point. They go on a 25-6 run to give themselves a pretty solid lead going into this halftime. And you got to like what you've seen so far from this team. Just a phenomenal job by players like Jade Hines, Clark. You got Parson, who's come and stepped up and done some good things for this team. But UMass won't go away. Perry got them started. But Phylloxi, Sosil, those young ladies have been able to get them back in here. Here are the points as they stand right now. For Richmond, Jade Hines Clark with 8, Amy Duggan has 2, Deja Ruffin has 5, Alex Parson with 7, Anaya Carpenter is 6, and Emma Squires has 3. For UMass, Sosil has 2, Lydell has 2, which is, Lydell has none, Sosil has 5, McCoy has 4, Perry has 9, Nelson has 3, Vera has 3, and Phylloxi has 4. For UMass, I think Lydell's going to have to be more of a presence in that second half if they want to win this ball game. She's a very important piece to that team. We'll see how things go as we head back to the broadcast and the third quarter. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back here with the second half of action here from the Robbins Center. The Richmond Spiders taking on the UMass men and women. 31-28, Richmond up in the contest so far as we start the third quarter. They switch sides. Question is, who is going to get things rocking and rolling here in the second half? Can Richmond hold on to this lead? Or can UMass bring it back, make the comeback? As of right now, Hines Clark driving to the inside with the floater. No good. Rebound by Hines Clark, but there's going to be a foul on the floor. Well, actually, that's a change of plans. They're going to say it was a kickball. Somebody's playing soccer today here on Super Bowl Sunday. 31-28. Rebound inside. Gives it over to Duggan. Duggan over to Mraz, over to Parson. Parson to Ruffin. Ruffin back to Parson at the top of the key. Mraz lost control of it, able to get it back to Parson, and then over to Ruffin. And Ruffin gets her first 2 points of the quarter. She's got 7. 33-28, Richmond up here with 9 minutes and 4 seconds in the third period. McCoy with the jump shot here for UMass off the back of the rim. Ruffin rebound. Up the floor to Parson. Parson takes a dribble of 2, swings to Mraz in the corner, inside to Hines Clark, who's going to be fouled. And I think this is going to be against Anil Sosil. And so Sosil is going to get the foul called against her. It's her first. And now Hines Clark heading to the free throw line. So Clark misses the first. And she will drain the second. 34-28 Richmond. And Perry. Vashney Perry over to George. George to McCoy. McCoy back to Perry. Perry inside looking for Lydell. And it's going to go over her head. And it will be Spiders basketball as the ball rolls out of bounds. Duggan takes it out, gives it over to Parson. Parson brings it up the floor here for the Lady Spiders. Pick attempt there by Hines Clark. Over to Parson. Parson to Mraz. on the right wing, back to Ruffin at the top of the key, and Burry, who comes straight towards the broadcast booth here. It's going to go out of bounds. She made a great hustle play there to try to save it, but it will stay with the Spiders. Parson takes the dribble, being guarded by Perry, goes behind the back again. Lost control of it, kicks it out to Mraz. She shoots it from, oh boy, I don't know how that one happened, but she shot it from close to the Spider logo, and it was like 2 seconds on the shot clock, and Hines Clark couldn't put it up in time. And now UMass basketball, 34-28, 7 minutes and 50 seconds on the clock. As Perry sits at the top of the key, slowing the pace down, gives it to George on the right wing. McCoy now has it at the top of the key. Over to Perry. Perry to Lydell for three, no good. Parson rebound up the floor, gives it to Ruffin. Ruffin falling, gives it to Hines Clark. And Ruffin with the assist. Great job there. And Hines Clark now has 11, 36-28, Richmond. 7 minutes and 17 seconds here on the clock. Fashney Perry being guarded by Hines Clark. Kind of took advantage of Hines Clark rolling off, trying to find her man on that one. And Richmond will get the ball off of the steal. Mraz for three, and she traveled. She hits the three. But she will be called for travel. Yeah, Hines Clark was looking for her assignment on that last one. Just couldn't find her. And Perry tried to take advantage of it. 36-28. Spiders up. Hampton Bay has it, drives into the basket, kicks it out to George, and George for three. Jessica George, one of the best shooters from three-point land in the A-10. You got to watch out for. They are the best shooting team in the A-10 from three-point land. And so you got to watch out for that, at least on the percentage front. Very accurate. 36-31, 6 minutes and 8 seconds. And Floxy is back in the game for UMass. Gives it over to Hampton Bay, also now in the game. Nelson in the game for UMass as well. Floxy driving, kicks across court, looking for Hampton Bay, who knocks it in for three. And all of a sudden, that 8-point lead is now a 2-point lead, 36-34. 5 minutes and 44 seconds left in this third quarter. Duggan on the left wing over to Carpenter, who's now in the game for the Spiders. Gives it to Mraz, who got it inside to Hines Clark. Lost control, but Ruffin is able to put it in. 38-34. Spiders up. 5:24. As Veloxi driving to the basket, and she took a hard one on that one, going up against Hines Clark. And she's going to get called for the foul. That's her third foul. I'll be honest with you, she was kind of just standing there. It felt like Veloxi just drove right into her, but I didn't see that much contact. Hines Clark's just baffled at this point. She's trying to figure out what happened. It looks like we're about to get Emma Squires back in the game here for Hines Clark. What a Squires. 38-35. Spiders up. 5:22 here in the third period. Veloxi makes the first free throw, looking to make the second. Make this a 2-point game. And she does just that. And now the men and women in the press. Mraz up the floor, swings it over to Ruffin on the right wing, back to Carpenter. And Carpenter to Mraz, right back to Carpenter, back to Mraz at the top of the key, swings it to Squires on the left wing, then to Duggan, who takes a cross court to Carpenter. And just great ball movement that ends up in Squire's hands, and she misses the three. Stolen by Carpenter. She's got two with her, gives it to Ruffin. Ruffin inside, tough, some contact there. Rebound by Duggan. There's a battle between her and Nelson. And this will... looks like it's going to stay... with the Spiders. All right, well, they're heading to a timeout with the score. The Spiders 38, UMass 36, with 4 minutes and 44 seconds left on the clock. Here on the clock left in the third period. As we get ready back for action here. Carpenter, Mraz, Duggan, Squires, Ruffin on the floor for the Spiders, Faloxi, Nelson, Hampton Bay, Liddell, and George in for the Minute Women. And Spiders basketball, Mraz taking it out, gets it inside to Duggan, who lost control of it, and there's a scramble on the floor, her and Hampton Bay, and it will be UMass basketball. Ruffin comes out of the game as Parsons will come in for the Spiders. 38-36. Very tight contest so far. Hampton Bay swings it to Faloxi in the near corner. Driving, oh, crossover, gets in between two defenders. Jump shot from the A-10 logo is good. This ball game is tied. Faloxi continues to impress. Good hustle there by Faloxi. Trying to get the steal, and it will be Spiders basketball steal. And we have Perry coming in for Faloxi. Well-deserved break there. That young lady, 8 points, 2 for 2 from the field, 4 for 4 from the free throw line, and 3 assists. And Perry on the break. Ooh, she lost control of it, and they're going to call a carrying violation on Perry. She just lost control of it. Could have gave UMass the lead on that one, but it will be Spiders basketball after the turnover. 3:59 here in the third period. 38-38. Carpenter has it, gives it over to Parson, who dribbles to the left elbow inside the Squires for 2 points. 40-38. George gives it to Hampton Bay on the right wing. Perry in the corner dribbles over to the right wing with the basketball now being guarded by Carpenter. 14 seconds on the shot clock. Hampton Bay being guarded by Parsons on the right wing, swings it over to George. George now over to Perry on the left wing. Liddell with the basketball. We haven't heard a lot from Haley today. Kicks it over to Hampton Bay for three, and that's going to be short and a shot clock violation. Shot clock violation. 40-38. Spiders continuing to hold on to a small 40-38 lead. Mraz swings it over to Carpenter in between the legs, being guarded by Liddell at the top of the key to Mraz. In the right wing to Parson, over to Duggan on the baseline, jumper no good. Squires battling down low with 3 minute women, Hampton Bay, Nelson, and Liddell, and it will stay with the Spiders. 2 minutes and 42 seconds on the clock. And Mraz gives it over to Carpenter. Carpenter to top, swings it on the right wing to Parson. Parson inside to Squires, who lost control. She tried to get it to Duggan. UMass has the basketball. George driving towards the basket, being guarded by Duggan. Great defense there by Duggan, forcing George to go back to the top of the key. Swings it over to Perry. Vashney, Perry hands it off to Hampton Bay, gives it to George inside, who looks... I'm not 100% sure if she was taking a shot or trying to dump it off there to Nelson, but It went out of bounds. It will be Spider basketball as Rivera, Hennessy Rivera, comes in the game. Hennessy Rivera comes into the game. 40-38. Carpenter has it. Takes a big dribble, give it in to Parson, down low to Hines Clark, kicks it to Mraz for three. Molly Mraz hits the three, it's a 5-point game. And now we have Philoxy heading back into the game for Purdy. 5-point lead here for the Spiders. A minute 51 on the clock. The UMass started off early looking good, and since then have struggled a little bit. Floxy with the crossover gives it to Rivera from the baseline. Jumper no good. Rebound Hines Clark. She lost control of Floxy, was right there with her. And I think that's going to stay with the Spiders. No, they're going to say it's going to be UMass basketball. The Spiders, hey, they got the ball, lost control of it. Veloxi was able to knock it away, and then it went out of bounds on her. And then Liddell shoots a three there, misses. Carpenter in the lane with the floater off the backboard for two. 7-point lead for Richmond. This Richmond team has really come along in the last few weeks. They're a different ball team than we saw at the beginning of the season. A lot of tough losses. Reminds me a lot of the men from last year. A lot of tough losses and then started to find their stroke in a 10 play. Oh, Squires got the rebound. Now we got a tussle. Hines Clark and Hampton Bay on the floor battling for the basketball. And it will be Spiders basketball. 45-38. 55 seconds on the clock. Carpenter brings it up the floor. 52 seconds on the clock. Here in the third quarter. Gives it inside to Hines Clark. And she gets it. Looks like she might have been looking for a foul on that one. 47-38. 9-point lead here for the Spiders. 33 seconds on the clock. Hampton Bay driving. Struggling on that one. Misses. Rebound Hines Clark. Parson. Slow it down here with 18 seconds on the clock. 9-point lead for the Spiders. Their biggest lead of the contest. 5 seconds. Carpenter pulls for three. Rolls off the side of the rim. And Rivera, throws it deep. It wouldn't have counted. Hits off the front of the rim. And that is it for the third quarter. The score of the Richmond Spiders, 47. The UMass Men and Women, 38, as we head into the fourth quarter. All right, everybody, here at the end of the third quarter, the Richmond Spiders holding a 47-38 lead over the UMass Men and Women. And what a great quarter by the Spiders. They found a way to get their biggest lead of the game right now, up by nine. UMass had tied it up at one point at 38-38. And then we ended that last a run there on a 9-0 run as we head into the fourth quarter. Jade Hines Clark right now has 13 points. She is 5 from 14 from the field, 3 for 4 from the free throw line with 10 rebounds, getting another double-double on the day. Now we're going to head you back to the broadcast for the fourth quarter. Fourth quarter underway. It has been a very highly contested ball game so far. Even though Spiders have kind of pulled away here in the last few minutes, only up by nine. UMass has come back once or twice already. And foul on Parson as Ruffin will come in the game for Mraz. 9-point lead, 9 minutes and 49 seconds on the clock. Vera has it after the inbound. Filoxi at the top of the key, being guarded by Carpenter. A little move there by Filoxi. Looks inside to Nelson and knocked away by Ruffin. Spiders have the basketball. Parson swings it right wing to Carpenter. Ruffin at the top of the key inside to Hines Clark, and she's going to be pushed by Nelson. And Hines Clark will head to the line. Hines Clark right now looking phenomenal. 13 points, 10 rebounds for Hines Clark. And she misses the first free throw. Hines Clark, the junior, 6'1", from Westwood, New Jersey. At the free throw line here. And she will miss both. Two critical misses right there. If you're UMass, you got to be smiling a little bit. At least you know, it's not an 11-point lead now. As Filoxi tries to get inside to Nelson. And it's going to go off her finger. And it will be Spider basketball. Carpenter bringing it up the floor here for the Spiders. 47-38, 9 minutes and 1 second on the clock. Duggan over to Ruffin at the top of the key. Inside to Hines Clark, who's got 13 already. Floater, no good. Rebound, Filoxi. Filoxi up the floor, Perry for three. She misses off the front, and Perry has kind of been cold since she had that amazing start to the game. She hit the first three threes for UMass, and she has gone quiet. Perry gets it into Liddell. Perry with Floxa back to Liddell. Liddell to Rivera. Being guarded by Duggan. Good defense there by Amy Duggan. Kicks it out to Perry at the top. Being guarded by Ruffin. Over to Filoxi. Over to Rivera, cross court to Perry. Inside to Nelson. And Hines Clark is there to knock it away. 6 seconds on the shot clock here for UMass. 8 minutes and 14 seconds on the clock. They get it into Liddell. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Liddell driving to the basket and travel. I'm just very shocked right now at the game that we've seen from Haley Liddell. She's been phenomenal all season. She's one of the best players in the A-10, second team preseason. She was on our third team last year. 47-38. Ooh, nice move here. Parson lost control of it almost. He ran into Hines Clark. Hines Clark got the ball, hands it over, swings it to Ruffin on the baseline, who drives towards the A-10 logo, takes the jumper, no good. 47-38, still a 9-point lead. 7 minutes and 43 seconds on the clock. Oh, nice job there. Hennessy's Rivera hits the jumper, 47-40. Parsons has it, and she drives. Hits the shot, but it will be no good. Foul is on the floor. Soysil will head back into the game here for Nelson. Parsons being guarded by Perry at the top of the key. Near the Spider logo. Gives it over to Mraz, and now kicks it to Ruffin at the top of the key. Back to Mraz on the right wing. Inside. Nice pass inside to Hines Clark. And Hines Clark has 15. 49-40. 9-point lead for the Lady Spiders. So with the timeout at 7 minutes and 8 seconds, the score, Richmond 49, UMass 40. We're about to head back here from the timeout. 49-40. Spiders up. 7 minutes and 8 seconds. Can the Spiders hold on to this lead and get their third straight victory? Third straight in the 8-10. If they can make that happen, it will be UMass basketball. Spiders up by 9 here. 7 minutes left in the fourth quarter. Great layup there by Purry. Fashney Purry drives straight to the basket with the scoop layup off the backboard. 49-42, 7-point game here. Moranz has it for Richmond. Over the roughing at the top of the key. Hines Clark takes a dribble. Tried to get it to Parson. Almost lost control. Rivera and Parson battling on the floor. And this will be Spiders basketball. And Carpenter will come into the game here for Richmond, for Ruffin, who's having herself a great game. Ruffin has 9 points today, 4 for 8 from the field, 1 for 3 from 3-point land, 3 rebounds and 2 assists. 49-42 is got the ref working hard out here today. Got him sweeping the floor, trying to clean up a wet spot from that battle on the floor. Duggan trying to get it in and finds Parson. He's looking for Carpenter initially, but great defense by Hampton Bay. Oh, look at that pick right there on Perry from Hines Clark. And then a great block by Rivera on Parson, who was driving to the basket. And Hines Clark picks up her fourth. She's going to have to leave the game. And Emma Squires comes in the game. 49-42. They were going to see a lot of Emma Squire here towards the end of this ball game. Purry with the layup high off the backboard, rolls off the rim. Another battle on the floor here. This time it's Rivera, Hampton Bay, and Carpenter. And the foul is on Squire. And that's her first foul. Rivera will take the ball out for UMass. Forty-9-42, 6 minutes and 10 seconds left in this fourth quarter. Purry right now sitting at 11 points on the game. Rivera for three, high three, no good. Rebound, Hampton Bay. And now Purry has it at the top of the key. Slowing things down. Down by 7 is this UMass men and women team. Can they make the comeback? Liddell with the pass, gives it into Rivera. A little bit of an aggressive bump there against Duggan. They kick it out to Perry for three. No good. Rebound, Hampton Bay. That's 2 straight rebounds by Hampton Bay. Just a hustle from last year's first team all-freshman member. Time is ticking. 5 minutes and 25 seconds. Shot clock at 17 inside to Liddell. And Liddell with a chance to score her first points of the day. And Haley Liddell has, you know, been non-existent in this ball game for UMass. 49-42. Liddell makes the first. So her first points of the game for Haley Liddell. She's got 1 point, looking to make it 2 here. 49-43. As Squires comes out of the game, Ruffin comes back in for the Spiders. Biloxi comes in for Hampton Bay. Liddell will knock it down. 49-44. 5 minutes and 20 seconds left in this fourth quarter. Can the Spiders hold off the Minute Women? Moraz has it on the right wing, gives it to Carpenter in the corner, who dribbles out to the right wing. Gives it over to Duggan at the top of the key, who gives it to Ruffin in the left wing, who kicks it to Parson from the corner. No good. And a good hustle there by Amy Duggan, but I believe this will be UMass basketball. 49-44. And we have a timeout on the floor, media timeout. Score 49-44. Spiders up with 4 minutes and 58 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Timeout's almost over here, 49-44. Spiders up with 4 minutes and 58 seconds here on Super Bowl Sunday. Patriots-Rams tonight, ladies and gentlemen, at 6:18, I believe, is the correct time the game will start. So it's always wonder why it was a weird time for the Super Bowl, but nevertheless, should be an interesting game tonight. We got a ball game in front of us right now as Veloxi gets it inside the Nelson. Nelson's going to get fouled. She's going to have a chance to make this a three-point ball game. Nelson, who's got 3 points in a day, she's 1-for-2 from the field and 1-for-2 from the free throw line. 2 rebounds, but she's got 3 personal fouls so far in this ballgame. And she misses. Critical miss there by Nelson. Every point counts here with this last 4:49 in this fourth quarter. And she makes the second. And it's a 4-point game. Ruffin dribbling over to the right side. Lost control of it. Perry with the steal. Fenise, Perry misses. Lydell inside for 2. And now Haley Lydell gets her first field goal of the game. And it's a 2-point game. And UMass is right back in this ball game as Coach Bader will call timeout. 49-47 with 4 minutes and 27 seconds on the clock in this fourth quarter. And the timeout is over. Spiders basketball, 49-47. Carpenter has it at the top of the key. Swings it over to Parson on the left wing. She takes a few dribbles, and there's a foul, and this one's going to be on Perry. Perry right now, who is the leading scorer for UMass in this ballgame with 11. Carpenter and Veloxi battling at the top of the key. Swings into Duggan on the right wing, being guarded by Lydell. Parson, top of the key over to Carpenter. Gives it down low to Hines Clark before she's fouled by Nelson. That's going to be her 4th. 49-47. Morass takes it out, kicks it to Parson. Parson using the Hines Clark pick to drive to the basket. Over to Carpenter. Carpenter back to Parson. Over to Mraz, back to Parson. Back to Mraz, back to Parson. Now over to Carpenter. Being guarded by Veloxi. Parson for 3 in the top of the key. 52-47. Alex Parson with the 3. She's got 10. She's the second Spider to hit double figures today. 5-point lead for Richmond. Trying to hold on to this one. Inside to Nelson from Lydell. No good. Rivera battling underneath, and the ball is loose. Spiders on the break. Carpenter in the inside, and she is going to be fouled, and she is hurt. She is down. She is holding her wrist, and I hope she's okay. And she took a very tough fall there. She went full blast on that fast break. And a very, very tough fall for Carpenter. Hope she's all right. So they're going to, they had a few people checking in on her, making sure she's all right. But she seems to be in a lot of pain. I mean, just a tough physical play. I mean, there was nothing malicious about it. Just fast break, nice pass from Parson to Carpenter, and took a pretty hard bump. And she's trying to move her wrist. And it looks like her wrist might be, and like I said, this is all speculation from here. It looks like she's favoring that wrist. And they're trying to get her to test it out, make sure she's all right. Now, with a 5-point lead, Richmond trying to get victory number 3 in the A-10. And UMass just trying to leave Virginia with another victory, or at least with a victory in hand after taking that tough loss to VCU the other day. And Carpenter's getting up. She seems to be all right. It might have been an initial shock for her, and they're still testing on her wrist. Looks like that's what they're messing with, but you know, when we get official word, we'll let you know. And we're going to head back to gameplay here. 3 minutes and 10 seconds left in this ball game. So Ruffin is heading to the free throw line for the Spiders. Ruffin, who's a graduate assistant, makes the first free throw, 6-point game. And the second one will rattle off, 53-47. Coach trying to give Perry a little direction on that one. Gives it over to Lydell. Lydell has it. Jump shot. And that's going to be short. Air ball rebound by Ruffin. That's going to be a foul on Rivera. And Ruffin will head to the line with an opportunity to add on. She's also in double figures after her last free throw. Duggan heads into the game. And Ruffin makes the first. She's got 11. 54-47, 2 minutes and 48 seconds on the clock. And she makes both. 8-point lead here for Richmond. Hines Clark has made her way back into the game. I know she'll be very careful here with this last 2 minutes and 48 seconds. If I'm UMass, I'm going straight four. I want her out of this game. You do not want her around. She's been very dominant for the Spiders. 55-47. 2 minutes and 36 seconds on the clock. Inside to Nelson. That's what they go for right off the bat. And that's, if that one is against her, wow, they did not waste time. And Hines Clark is out of this ball game. They strategically, we just said it, you know, they're going to go right after. They went down low to Nelson, and Hines Clark fouls out of this game. She was only in maybe 15 seconds before they got her out of the ball game. And, you know, her great performance today, nevertheless, getting her 6th double-double of the year. Right now in the top 3 in the A-10. And Nelson misses. Nelson's free throws have cost this team just a little bit. 2-4. And she makes that one. So she's 50% from the line. 55-48. Squires gets it in. To Parson, I think we're heading back to the free throw line. Parson heading to the line, 55-48. And Parson, who has 10 points on the day. Her day looks like this. 10 points, 4 for 6 from the field, 2 for 3 from 3-point land. A rebound and 3 assists. And she makes the first free throw. She has 11. 56-48. And she makes both. That's going to give her 12 points. What a good performance here by the Spiders. 57-48. Hampton Bay coming off the Nelson pick. Drives to the basket with the left. No foul. Oh, just a great play there by Hampton Bay. Great defense by Duggan. She throws the ball back in to Hampton Bay. And what are they calling here? Because they didn't call a foul initially on Duggan, but it looked like they are discussing something in that range. They didn't call a foul. She grabs it. She throws it back in. And it should be a travel. At least it should be a travel on Hampton Bay. She caught the ball and fell straight to the ground. Okay, we're waiting to hear the decision here. And I'm thinking that they're going to give. Yeah, they called a foul on Deja Ruffin. And that's going to send Hampton Bay to the line. I'd have to see the replay one more time to see if she was nearby. ...57-48, 9-point lead for Richmond. 2 minutes and 16 seconds on the clock. It was a very interesting fourth quarter. Hampton Bay. And it goes in. Hampton Bay right now has 6 points. Make it 7. 57-50, 2 minutes and 16 seconds. And Squires passes it in to Parson. Parson bringing it to the floor here for the Spiders. Being guarded by Hampton Bay. Travel. She took an extra step. And UMass basketball. ...57-50. Less than 2 minutes left in the ball game. Unless UMass can make a comeback run here, either send this bad boy in the overtime or win it. You got Duggan and Nelson battling down low. Paloxi looking inside. And once again, this one is on Parson. Another foul, and we got Veloxi hitting to the free throw line. Veloxi has been amazing. In the 2 games I've had an opportunity to see her play. And now she's heading to the free throw line, the freshman from Queens, New York. And she misses. It's her first miss of the day, free throw or field goal. And she shoots the second, and she misses both. Rebound by Parson. Looking up the floor, she's got Ruffin. And Ruffin smartly slows it down and then kicks it back out. Minute 40. Parson has it at the top, being guarded by Hampton Bay. Ruffin has it, swings it over to Parson. Parson being guarded by Hampton Bay. Back this time to Squires. Squires driving towards the basket. A lot of contact. And now a very late charging call there. He waited a second, and then calls the charge. It was a charge. Just a little hesitation there. I guess he wanted to make sure it was right. 57-50, minute 24 left. Nelson takes a dribble, hands it off to Hampton Bay. Hampton Bay takes a dribble, hands it off to Rivera. Liddell for 3! And you knew Haley Liddell would show up eventually. And right there, Haley Liddell hits a 3. It's a 4-point game with a minute and 10 here in the fourth quarter. Liddell, after that 3, now has 7 points on the day. She was 2 for 7. From the field, 1 for 3 from three-point line and 2 for 2 from the free throw line. But she's got 7 rebounds today. So 7 points, 7 rebounds for Liddell. And we got a minute 10 left. 30-second timeout's almost over. I tell you what, man. Just when you think they're out of the mix, They find a way to get right back in that bad boy. ...57-53... Opportunity here for UMass. They're getting a little bit closer. Spider's got to find a way to hold this one off. And then we have a timeout by Coach Bader. So the Spiders will call a timeout. 57-53 with a minute 10 left in this ball game. 57-53. Minute 10 left. Timeout is over. Looking deep to Squires, and they lost control on the pass, and it will be UMass basketball. It was a good thought, but the pass goes a little astray. And UMass basketball, 4-point lead. Minute and 9 left in the period. And so Coach Pate is trying to plead his case. So right now it looks like they're going to have a little discussion. Maybe check and see who touched the ball last. And Coach Pater was very adamant. We'll find out what happened here as they're checking the tape. And once again, our next broadcast will be next Wednesday, the following Wednesday on the 13th here from the Robbins Center as the Richmond Spiders take on St. Bonaventure. And we'll have that one for you here on the Legacy Maker Sports Network. Then also, we will have VCU versus Dayton the following night. So that's the February 13th here at the Robbins Center and February 14th at the Siegel Center. And we'll be able to catch Dayton in action versus the VCU Rams. So discussion looks to be over, and we're waiting to see what the final result is. And they're saying that it will be UMass basketball, minute and 9. UMass 57-53. Minute left in this ball game. Missed by Philoxi. Rebound by Ruffin. Ruffin trying to bring it up the floor. Hampton Bay trying to steal it from behind. Will be called for the foul here with 53 seconds on the clock. 4-point lead. And Ruffin heading to the line with a chance to extend the lead up by 4. And she makes the first. 58-53. 5-point lead for the Spiders. She makes both. Huge by Ruffin. She's got 14. 59-53. As we got another timeout. 53.7 seconds left in the ball game. I tell you what, you got to love the play. I mean, both contests we've done the last two games for you with UMass involved, tight games, competitive games. They're going to fight. They're going to be in the mix. And they've done that in this game, but they have not been able to get over the hump. They started off great, just like they did against VCU, but just second quarter, things led the other way in both of these contests. So right now, Spiders with a 6-point lead. And I'm going to tell you what, if you're a person who loves basketball, these two teams will be going against each other at the Siegel Center. Richmond versus VCU, crosstown rivalry, will happen next Saturday. Fortunately, we'll not be able to bring you the broadcast. We will be at the UVA-Duke matchup, number 2 in the country. The Duke Blue Devils take on the number 3 Virginia Cavaliers and John Paul Jones Arena will be there for that action. Unfortunately, we'll not be able to see it. We will have Russ Taliaferro will be there to bring you blow-by-blow coverage of the game for the network. So 53.7 seconds as Hampton Bay will take it out here for UMass. She gets it over Phloxi. Phloxi being guarded by Parson. 50 seconds left. Liddell for three. Misses off of the backboard. Nothing but backboard on that one, and it will be Spiders basketball. Seemed like Liddell kind of rushed that one. Didn't get her feet set. And we have a Spider timeout. So 59-53 after the timeout by Coach Pater. Spiders trying to hold on to this one, and there will be a foul. So both teams getting together here, trying to figure out how to finish this one up with 45 seconds on the clock. And Ruffin's going to head to the line here. And she's got a chance to extend the lead just a little bit more. And right now, she's sitting at 14 points. And she misses that one. And that one bounces off, and Ruffin missed both free throws. And it's going to be UMass basketball. Phloxi was like, wait a minute, man, I didn't touch that. And so now Phloxi trying to get it up the floor. And there's going to be a foul. Alex Parson now has her fourth foul. So Hines Clark, who's already out of the game, now have to be careful because they could lose Parson. They still have a six-point lead here with 40 seconds. So they're still in good shape. The ref has had a fantastic game. And makes the first is Phloxi. Phloxi has nine. And she makes the second. And there's a battle underneath the basket, and they're trying to see who's going to have the basketball. They're going to say Spiders basketball. But Cliff Verde's like, nah. He doesn't seem too thrilled about it. This has been a very long fourth quarter. The other three quarters flew by. We're looking at at least a 40-minute close to a 40-minute fourth quarter here. A lot of fouls in this fourth quarter. And now Parsons head to the line. And she makes the first. It's a five-point ball game. 39.7 seconds, 60-55. Richmond up over UMass. Just trying to close in on victory number three in the A-10. And she misses the second rebound by Nelson. Hampton Bay up the floor to Phloxi. Phloxi kicks it out to Rivera for three. Bangs it in, and UMass is down by two. Mraz being pressured, roughing, and there's going to be a foul on Phloxi. But just like that, this is a two-point ball game, 27.3 seconds on the clock. Man, what a ball game this has been. I tell you, every time you thought UMass was out of the game, they stuck their nose right back in it. And Ruffin has a chance again to extend the lead. She missed her last two. And she misses that one. That's a rough one right there. No pun intended. 5 for 9 from the free throw line. And she makes it. 61-58, three-point game with 27.3 seconds on the clock. Don't be surprised if Lydell is the person that takes this next shot. Inside to Nelson with the baby hook. No good. And Spiders basketball. I think it was last touch by UMass. 18.9 seconds on the clock. I think UMass could have held off on that a little bit, maybe worked the clock a little bit more. As we have a timeout, 18.9 seconds. Spiders 61, UMass 58. It has been a ball game, a very exciting ball game here at the Robin Center on Super Bowl Sunday. Now, we talked a little bit about the game that happens tonight, and that game will be the New England Patriots taking on the St. Louis Rams. Excuse me, the L.A. Rams. It's still kind of hard to forget that they are the St. Louis Rams. It's almost like San Diego Chargers or L.A. Chargers. Both just kind of mess with your mind. But we should be installed for a big Super Bowl tonight. But this game right here has been exciting. This is definitely the way to start it off if you're a sports fan. Oh, they jamming in the arena. They said it takes two to make a thing go right. All right, so both teams still in deep discussion here. And yesterday we got a chance to cover some big games. UVA defeating the Miami Hurricanes 59 to 49. And then VCU getting the W over George Mason last night in a great contest. Richmond Spiders lost a tough one to LaSalle last night, the men. But A-10 is starting to warm up. The ACC is starting to warm up. Next, like I said, next Saturday, Duke versus UVA is going to be a doozy. It should be a really good contest. Live from JPJ. It looks like they're actually reviewing who touched that ball last, and that's what's taking so long here. At first glance, it definitely looked like it was out on UMass, and I'm getting a chance to look at it now, and there's two players based off of the vision that I'm getting that touch the basketball. It looked like it might have been Ruffin and Hampton Bay, and I don't really know how you can say, you know, in the NFL they say that's conclusive. It's not conclusive. It doesn't look conclusive here. I don't know how they're going to make this decision. This is going to be a tough one. And discussions are still deep here. And now we got Jeopardy music. Oh, that's hilarious. Who's the sound guy here? And so now both coaches coming together as they make this decision. All right, so it will be UMass. They're saying it's going to be UMass basketball. Oh, well, okay here. So UMass basketball, like from what I saw, I couldn't tell. But now UMass has a chance with 19.3 seconds. They readjust the clock to tie this ball game. Watch out for Haley Lattell. I'm telling you. She's going to be the one to look for. Rivera, Hampton Bay, driving, kicks it out to Rivera for three. Hits off the side of the backboard. Nelson had a chance for the rebound, and it hit off her chest. And with 5.3 seconds, Richmond has the basketball and the chance to clinch this one. And they're sending Mraz to the line. So Hampton Bay has fouled out of the game, and Philoxy will come back in. So Mraz, if she hits both, this game is pretty much over. If she hits one, there's a slight chance. If she misses both, then that means UMass has a huge opportunity. It looks like we're having more discussion. What's this one? There's been a lot of reviews. This has been a long fourth quarter. We're hitting at the 40-minute mark now with this fourth quarter. A lot of fouls in this fourth quarter. And she misses. That's critical because if she misses this second one, 6.2 seconds on the clock. They readjusted it. Do not be surprised if UMass calls the timeout. And she makes it. Huge 4-point lead. Filoxi taking it up the floor, trying to get it there as fast as she can. Driving straight to the basket. Spin move inside. Misses, and that's it. The Richmond Spiders win this ball game 62-58. Big matchup. Big game. Big 8-10. That's number three in a row for Richmond. And unfortunately for UMass, they take this UVA trip and they end up 0-2 on the trip. Both teams have great games coming up here in the next few days. Should be some big ones. Duquesne and UMass. We'll see that on Thursday. And then we'll see Richmond versus Dayton on Wednesday. All right, everybody. Darrell Owens, Legacy Maker Sports Network. Thanks for tuning in. Spiders win 62-58.
That's why we were able to pull that one out. I think once we start getting in a rhythm and we play together as a team, we can do anything. So going into this game, we knew that we needed to stick together and focus the whole time.
Now right now, Jane, three straight victories. Y'all look like y'all really come together. Can you tell me about the winning streak?
Yeah, this winning streak, it feels good. You know, we were off to a rough start. We're a very young team, so having this three-game winning streak has really given us a boost as a team. And individually, it's given every single one of our players some confidence.
Now, you got Dayton this week. Big matchup. What are your thoughts on that matchup against Dayton?
Big matchup. I think if we can rebound and if we can limit our turnovers, we'll do well. I think if we continue to play as a team, we can beat them.
All right. That's Jane Hines-Clark, Richmond Spiders. They get the W today, 62-58 over the UMass Minute.